celiac disease, also known as gluten intolerance, is an autoimmune disorder of the small intestine that acute and genetically predisposed people of all ages. In the majority of the cases, it is an inherited disease, so that's why we frequently there is more than one person in a family that suffers from this disease.
Gluten is a protein found in wheat and similar crops such as barley and rye. Gluten causes inflammatory reactions in people who are intolerant to it and also atrophies the intestinal villi, which are responsible for the absorption of the nutrients and slows this process. Approximately 30% of the population has a genetic base compatible with this disease, but only 1% of the population develop it, and moreover, only 25% is diagnosed. That means a part of the population is living without knowing they are intolerant to gluten, so they are on diets which are harmful for them.
Celiac disease has numerous symptoms, around 300 different. The main symptoms that this disease presents include growth problems, decreased appetite and failure to gain weight, chronic diarrhea, vomiting, fatigue and irritability. Sometimes these symptoms appear when the individual is triggered by a stressful situation, and the affectation is normally more harmful in children and adolescents than in adults. To diagnose celiac disease, there are different tests which determine if someone has or suffers from this disease. These tests include blood tests, endoscopies and pathological tests. The main problem that celiacs have to face is the reduced variety of food which is fully available for them. In fact, this problem is very closely related with the labeling in food products. The information displayed in the labeling has several problems in countries such as Spain and France, while in the United Kingdom the labeling is available for the entire public. This depends on the governments and the development of their social ideas and the knowledge for this type of diseases. In countries like Spain, there aren't any laws which force companies to state about any allergy information, and only have to do so those food products which are specifically made to meet special necessities. There are lots of different symbols which mean free from gluten. Prices in gluten-free products are much more expensive than gluten-containing food products. This is caused because of the reduced production of this specific product, and moreover because lots of gluten-free products are handmade. The VAT on this kind of food is 10% more expensive than the normal ones.
The main medication for celiac people is their alimentation, but the government doesn't agree with this affirmation, and although a celiac person spends on average 1,500 euros more on food per year than a person who is not celiac, it's not willing to help economically celiac patients. In Spain, there isn't any kind of help to celiac people, with the exception of Navarra. The situation is very different in the rest of Europe, where celiac patients live in better conditions. Ireland and Italy are the most advanced countries in this sense. There are benefits in the income statement for all the food without gluten consumed, and for prescription medicine and special food, Iberians spend a maximum of 120 euros per month. In Italy, where the main food is pasta which contains gluten, the celiac people receive between 45 and 94 euros per month, from 6 months to 10 years. Thereafter, men receive 140 euros per month and women 90 euros. The majority of European countries certify the quality of their non-containing gluten products, but in Spain, to know about gluten-free food, people should join a private association, and that includes the payment of an annual fee. Different associations have been rising with a common and main goal, which is to make the life of celiac easier. The Catalan Association birthed in 1976, and among other objectives, it aims to inform and protect celiac patients and to improve their life quality. In Spain, there is an association for each community, which are federated in FACE. In the same way, there is a European association, another for youth celiac.
Celiac disease is a reality that is increasing and more people will suffer from this disease. So governments need to start changing their approach and to start considering this minority group, which nowadays is not considered, and they will get bigger as years go by. There's the need of changes since there isn't an established situation on this disease. Governments should take more responsibility on how to improve the situation. The few things that have been achieved have been thanks to small groups or organizations which have created some pressure, but there is still a lot to do to satisfy the social necessities.